This is Andrew from DB Services, and today I would like to show off a FileMaker SurveyMonkey integration. So what is SurveyMonkey? SurveyMonkey is a website that lets you design and send out surveys to people and collect their responses. And SurveyMonkey also lets you analyze and kind of see the metrics behind all the responses, like give you what the most common answers were, stuff like that, just basic analysis. It's very popular for like customer satisfaction surveys and kind of viewing your responses and seeing how well you did. But anyway, using FileMaker and the FileMaker's data API and SurveyMonkey's API, we can use webhooks, set webhooks to individual surveys and collect all the data from SurveyMonkey and put it directly into your FileMaker file. So, to do this, I'm going to go through all the steps over here. It's a lot simpler than it looks, I promise. So let's just go through this list. Okay, so the first thing you're going to have to do, you're going to have to host this file, otherwise it will not work. And then two, you will need to go to the application registration portal on SurveyMonkey and create an application. And now is a good time to note, you're going to need a Premier or higher plan with SurveyMonkey, or else you will not be able to create an API, or an app rather, for which you can call from the API. So let's make a new app. I'm going to make it a private app. You're going to have to give it a name. So I'm just going to say FileMaker 2, since FileMaker 1 already exists. Hit create app. And then you're going to also, while you're here, go to settings, scroll down, and edit the scopes. So the scopes is what you want it to have access to. So what I recommend is view responses, create modify webhooks, view webhooks, view collectors, view surveys, and view response details. And once you have those six selected, you can hit update scopes. And while you're also here, you're going to want this access token to put into the test file. So I'm just going to hop on back here. So we did this. We made an app. We set the required scopes. And here we have the access token. So I already have an access token from the previous webhook I set up. So I'm just going to leave that as is. And what you can do now with the access token in there is get all the surveys currently on your account. So once you click that button with the access token in, it should pull in all the information on the right. And from here, you can set which ones you want to tie a webhook to. So I just want test survey. I don't want the fast food. And with that, you will also have to update the dbaccess.php file. So there should be two PHP files attached in this download. And basically, this allows you to talk to the FileMaker data API and bring everything into FileMaker. So you're going to have to update this file. Over here, I have it open. You'll have to update lines 11 through 14. And the only things you have to edit is where the address of the server of where you hosted the FileMaker file, the name of the FileMaker file, the REST API enabled username, and that password for that username. And once you have all those four things put in, save the file, and you're also going to have to, so those are all those four steps, you're going to have to submit, you're going to have to host submit survey.php and dbaccess.php, and the URL of where they are hosted should go in right here. So I already have them hosted, so the URL is already in there. And now you just have to set the webhooks information. So these are the defaults I'm going to leave in with the system. Name of the webhook, the layout of where you want the webhook request stuff to be saved, the field of where it's going to be saved, and the script you want to run after the fact. So with all that set in, we're going to hit create webhook. And you're going to get a response if it's successfully created. So good for us, successfully created. And now we are going to go submit a survey to see if it worked. So if I go, so we attached it to the test survey over here. I'm going to go collect a new response. And before we do that, I'm just going to confirm that there are no responses currently available. So if I hit view example, this is the previous response that I ran through. But anyway, we are going to go back and add a new collector. I'm going to just do a web link. So I'm just going to fill out the survey real fast. If I go to this URL, I'm just going to say question one, I select option four. Yay. Question two, I'm going to do choice two. Question three, testing. One, two, three. Test again. So now that I submit this, the webhook should catch all the information and add a new record once all that information is done processing. So right now we have three records. Once the webhook is done processing all the information, there we go. We have the fourth record come in. So we have pulls in all the information we selected from the SurveyMonkey webhook and just posts it directly into FileMaker. And that's really all there is to it. If you have any questions, please contact us regarding the SurveyMonkey integration. And thank you.